V for Vendetta. Created by Alan Moore and David Lloyd. Narrated by Matyas Job Gombos. V for Vendetta. Good evening, London. It's 9 o'clock, and this is the Voice of Fate, broadcasting on 275 and 285 in the medium wave. It is the 5th of the 11th, 1997. The weather will be fine until 12:07 a.m., when a shower will commence lasting until 1:30 a.m. The temperature will vary between 13 and 14 degrees centigrade throughout the night. The people of London are advised that the Brixton and Streatham areas are quarantine zones as of today. It is suggested that these areas be avoided for reasons of health and safety. Productivity reports from Herefordshire indicate a possible end to meat rationing starting from mid-February 1998. This good news follows similar announcements concerning the increased production of both eggs and potatoes. Police raided 17 homes in the Birmingham area early this morning, uncovering what is believed to be a major terrorist ring. 20 people, 8 of them women, are currently in detention awaiting trial. Queen Zara today appeared at the opening of a new waste reclamation plant in Plaistow. This was the Queen's first public appearance since her 16th birthday in June. The Queen was wearing a suit of peach silk, created specially for the occasion by the Royal Couturier. In a speech today, Mr. Adrian Carroll, Party Minister for Industry, stated that Britain's industrial prospects are brighter than at any time since the last war. Mr. Carroll went on to say that it is the duty of every man in this country to seize the initiative and make Britain great again. And that is the face of London tonight. We remind you that tomorrow is the final date for the completion of your census forms, and the target date for the conclusion of the Deptford Marsh Clearance Project. This is the Voice of Fate, signing off. Have a pleasant evening. Chapter 1. The Villain. Parliament's cold shadow falls on Westminster Bridge, and she shivers. There was power here once, power that decided the destiny of millions. Her transactions, her decisions, are insignificant. They affect no one.
Mister?
Except her.
Would you like to, sleep with me or anything? I mean, for money?
That's the clumsiest piece of propositioning I've ever heard. You've not been doing this very long, have you?
Oh, God. I must be really terrible. Yeah, you're right. It's my first night. You're my first...
customer?
Customer, yeah. I've got a job in munitions, but the money is, you know, it isn't enough. Look, mister, I really need that money. I'd be okay. I mean, I'm 16, I know what I'm doing.
No, you don't know what you're doing. Because if you did, you wouldn't have picked a vice detail on stakeout.
Oh, Christ, you're a finger man.
That's right. And these are my colleagues. You know, the laws on prostitution, That's a Class H offense. That means we get to decide what happens to you. That's our prerogative.
Oh, no, look, please, mister, it was my first time. I'll do anything you want. Please don't kill me.
You've got it wrong, miss. You'll do anything we want. And then we'll kill you. That's our prerogative.
Oh, please. Don't. Oh, Jesus, no, please.
The multiplying villainies of nature do swarm upon him.
Who the hell?
And fortune on his damned quarrel, smiling, showed like a rebel's whore.
Who's he?
I don't know, must be some kind of retard got out of a hospital. Hey, you! But all's too weak for brave Macbeth. Well, he deserves that name.
What are you doing? You're in trouble, chum. Big trouble. This woman is a criminal. We're police officers. She's wanted for interrogation, so keep your...
hands off?
Disdaining fortune with his brandished steel, which smoked with bloody execution. Like Valor's minion, carved out his passage, till he faced the slave.
Oh!
Which ne'er shook hands, nor bade farewell to him.
Tear gas! Oh, holy Christ! It's tear gas!
I got his hand. What shall I do with his...
Oh, Jesus.
What the hell happened?
He just came out of nowhere and just... What the hell happened?
Frank's dead.
They're all dead. Oh, Christ, what are we going to do?
Find him. We've got to find him where the head will have our guts.
How did he do it? I've never seen anybody move so fast. He killed Frank!
That bastard. We've got to find him.
You... You rescued me. Like in a story. I don't believe it. Who are you?
Me? I'm the king of the 20th century. I'm the boogeyman. The villain. The black sheep of the family.
Yeah, but what were you doing around here? I didn't think anybody came to Westminster at night except, you know, women.
Ah, but tonight is special. Tonight is a celebration. A grand opening. Were you never taught the rhyme? Remember, remember, the 5th of November, the gunpowder treason and plot. I know of no reason why the gunpowder treason should ever be forgot.
Oh, oh, the Houses of Parliament, they've been... Did you do that?
I did that.
But that's against the law. They'll kill you. Did you really do that?
I really did that. Now, hush, there's more.
The rumble of the explosion has not yet died away. As far from below comes the rattle of smaller reports. And suddenly, the sky is alight with...
fireworks! Real fireworks! Oh, God! They're so beautiful!
And all over London, windows are thrown open, and faces lit with awe and wonder gaze at the omen scrawled in fire on the night.
There! The overture is finished. Come! We must prepare for the first act.
Me? But... Oh, okay.
It is precisely 12:07 a.m. It begins.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.